Hello students, in this lesson let us study about the size of the apron, and in particular we will study the number of gates. So this is the second factor that will affect the size of the apron. So in the previous lesson we have already studied the gate position. So to get started with, normally the number of gates which should be provided is determined based on the predominant hourly flow of aircraft. Predominant or predetermined, you can say, hourly flow of aircraft. So what does this mean? In 1 hour, how many of aircrafts are coming into the gates, we have to determine. The most frequent one or the highest one we have to take and then decide on the number of gates. There are many factors on which the number of gates will depend. The first one is the estimated peak hour volume. So on the peak hour, how much of aircrafts have come into the gates, we have to determine, and then that will help us to find the number of aircrafts. So normally if we want to have a balanced airport design, this volume, whatever we have calculated, that is the estimated peak hour volume, should not exceed the capacity of the runway, or else there will be congestion in the traffic. The second point is the gate occupancy time. Now what exactly is this gate occupancy time? Is the amount of time an aircraft occupies a gate or is in a gate. Okay. So it depends upon many factors. Right? What is the amount of time an aircraft is staying in a gate? It will depend upon many factors like the size, of aircraft, then based on the type of operation it is performing, right? Whether it is a through flight or a turnaround flight. So based on that, also, it will depend. Normally, what will happen if it is a through flight, then it may require little flight time as there is no service, and consequently, the gate occupancy time may be as low as about 20 to 30 minutes. This is for your through flight. On the other hand, if the flight is a turnaround flight, then the gate occupancy time may vary somewhere between 40 to 60 minutes. So these are the standards. It can also vary from these particular times. The third one is the gate capacity analysis. So the base of the gate capacity analysis is that the gate time demanded by the aircraft should be less than or equal to the gate time supplied for the aircraft. Now, what does this mean? Suppose a flight is given a gate time of about, say, 1 hour, then it has to come out of the gate before 1 hour or exactly at the 1 hour. It should not exceed that particular time. Normally, there are two models which are developed for determining the capacity of the gates. So, the first type is the unrestricted gate use. And the second type is the restricted gate use. So in unrestricted gate use, it is assumed that any type of aircraft which is coming into the airport can use this particular type of gate. So any aircraft. Whereas when it comes to restricted gate use, then there is a certain size or airline that can use this gate, and they are specifically designed for those type of aircrafts or those type of airlines. Okay, so we can write it as certain size or airlines. Okay, moving on to the fourth point. The fourth point is the gate utilization factor. Now, it is unlikely that all the gates available at the terminal building are used for 100% of their capacity, right? So it occurs due to various situations, like, say, for example, if the aircraft moving in and out of the gate often block the other aircraft which is attempting to move in and out of the gate, then we cannot use that particular type of gate, right? So that is one of the reason we are not able to utilize. So 100% utilization might not happen all the time. One of the reason is this, and the other reason being that the time gap between the successive aircraft scheduled may be too small for other gates to be used by the other flights. So normally what will happen, the airports where all the gates are used mutually by all the airlines, the utilization factor will be somewhere around 0.6 to 0.8. So here all gates are used by all airlines. Gates by all airlines. In some airports where the gates are used for particular type of exclusive airlines, then the utilization factor may drop down. So for somewhere around 0.5 to 0.6. So here the gates are used by exclusively different airlines. Right. Finally, moving on to the fifth point is the formula which is required for calculating the gate capacity. We need to see what is the formula. So the formula says is G is equal to CT by U, where G is the number of gates, C is the design volume, or we can say capacity of gate in the aircraft per hour for arrivals as well as the departures. T is the weighted average gate capacity time. And this is normally in hours. And finally, U is the coefficient indicating gate utilization factor. Which we have studied in the point number 4. Now, this above formula is used for airports where there is no restriction on the use of gates and all aircrafts can use the gates all the time. If we are going for restricted gate use, the mix of gates and the mix of aircraft using the airports may not be same. So under such circumstances, what we have to do, the gate capacity of each type of gate is found out, and then the minimum gate capacity is taken to determine the overall capacity of the airport. Right. So hope this lesson is clear to you. Further, moving on to the next lesson, we will solve certain problems on the calculation of the gate capacity. Thank you.